My name is Holly DeSherry, and I am making my first YouTube video today. So I just got the Jaclyn Hill and Morphe palette in the mail. Yes, it is a huge rage. I know everyone's making videos with it, but just like everyone else, I was super excited to get my hands on it and to dig in and see what I could do. So my boyfriend was like, Holly, why don't you film a look that you can do for the 4th of July. So I was like, okay, why not? So I dug in and I created this look right here. And it doesn't take that long. I didn't use false lashes because I know, you know, most people don't want to use false lashes. But I created this look and I had so much fun doing it. And so I hope you guys do enjoy this video. If you have any other looks that you'd like to see, feel free to comment down below. And I will link everything that I used down below as well. So, I hope you have fun and enjoy this video. So, today I am going to be doing a look on the new Jaclyn Hill palette that is raving in the beauty industry right now, I'm completely aware. And many of her fans, including me, were super excited to get this in the mail. So, I decided I was going to do a little look for my first video on YouTube. And I'll give you a little bit of background as to why I'm going to do this. Jaclyn Hill was one of the first YouTubers that I started watching in makeup, and I'd always been interested in makeup, and I played around with it all the time. And when I came across her first video, it was how to do flawless foundation, and I just remember sitting there watching her, and she was so real and so honest, and everything that she did, she explained why she did it, and I thought it was really cool, especially for people who are trying to learn or who just, you know, want to know why you do certain things. I found it really, really interesting and really helpful that she was honest and helpful, so and descriptive on what she was doing. So that's kind of why I wanted to use her palette today. So for today, I already have my foundation on and my eyes are already prepped and ready to go. So the first shade that I'm going to go in today is MFEO. So if you have the palette, this is the sheet that you get to go with it. And in the palette, the first shade, MFEO, is going to be this shade right here. And I'm going to take that on a Sigma E38 brush. It's pretty dense. And I'm going to put that in the crease of my lid, starting low and working my way up, windshield wiper motions in and out, and I'm going to tuck it into that crease right here. Let's see, I'm going to zoom in for you guys. This shade is a wonderful transition color, which I know that she said was the purpose of making this shade, so that you can have just a great transition color basically for any kind of look that you want to create. Okay, next shade that I am going to go in with is going to be Pukey, which is this shade right below the MFEO in the palette. I'm just not going to show the palette every time, but it's the shade right below that. And I'm going in with this Morphe brush. I bought it in a set of brushes, so it doesn't have the numbers on it, but it is pretty tapered and it's shorter on the sides and comes to a point so that you can really get in there and really buff things out. So I'm going to start on the outer corner of the lid and really push this into the crease. Okay, next I'm going to go in with the shade Butter, which is this shade right here in the palette. And I'm going to take that same Morphe brush. And I'm going to focus this down. Start pushing it down on the lid. And then working my way up. And just in circular motions, bringing it in. If you start lower on the lid, you can always build your way up. But if you start too high, then it may end up getting a little bit too close to your eyebrow, especially if you have small eyelids. You don't want to bring it up too high. And if you don't have a crease, you can always create a crease with your eyeshadows. That's the point of doing so many different shades, is that you can build depth and dimension with your shadows. You want to blend so that everything comes together and you can't see those distinct lines throughout. So that'll make your eyeshadow not look very well. And the point is, you want to, when you're doing makeup, you're an artist, and anytime an artist is doing any sort of work, they want to blend their colors together. So that's what you want to do. You want to be an artist on your face. Okay, next I am going to go in with the shade Hunt, which is this color right here. There we go. And I'm going to go in with a MAC 217 brush. And I'm just going to pack that on the outer corner of the lid. Almost going in like a diagonal downward. And just pressing it in. And I know that you lost it. Whoa, baby, I got the gold, and I know that you're gone. Then I'm gonna go in with a clean brush. This is a MAC 224 brush, and I'm just gonna go in and kind of buff that out. Really just blending all of those shades together that I have already put on the lid. Then I'm gonna go in with the shade Roxanne, which is the shade here, lightly. And I'm gonna push that into that crease really well. And I'm using that same Morphe brush from earlier that was shorter on the edges and it got longer in the center, and I just lightly pushed into that color, and now I'm pushing it into my crease, just mostly on the outer corner. I am going to go in with the shade Crayon Apple, which is this shade right here, and it's another brush from that Morphe collection, but it's just a flat brush. A lot of people like the MAC, I think 242, but this one works great. And we're just gonna pack that on to our lid, not all the way to the center, but from about right here on my lid, and work it out. Then I'm going to go in with the shade Faint, which is this one on the top right here. And I'm going to use the opposite side of that brush. And this is a lot lighter of a shade. It has a pink-ish hue, but with the mix of colors that I'm blending together, it's just going to look a little bit more red. Bring some brightness. And I am working that into the corner of my eye and somewhat over that Crayon Apple that I just used. Baby, when I smoke with you, I feel so free. Okay, next I'm gonna go in with the shade Firework. Right here. I don't know if that's focusing or not. There we go, right there, Firework. and I'm gonna push that in the center of my lid to really blend all these colors together. Okay, next I'm gonna go back in with that tapered brush, and I am going to dip back into the shade Pukey from earlier, and I'm gonna go in again into that crease just to really blend those colors that I just used into my crease so that there are no super harsh lines. Okay, next I'm gonna go in with a Morphe 506 brush, and I am going to use the shade Jax, which is right here. And I am going to create almost like a cut crease, but not quite. I just wanna really like darken my outer crease. So I'm gonna take this brush and really just lightly push it into this outer crease. Okay, then I'm gonna go back in with that tapered brush with a little bit of that MFEO color and push it in just to really blend out that shade. Okay, so now that everything on the lid is pretty blended out, I'm gonna move on to the lower lash line, and I'm gonna use the Chanel brush that looks like this. And I'm going to go back in with the shade Pukey, and I am going to buff it on my lower lash and kind of buff it into blend with the top shadows. Next, I'm going to go in with this smaller Chanel brush, and I'm going to go in with the shade Jada right here. I'm not going to take very much of it. I'm just going to barely tap it in there, and it's going to kind of set up what I'm wanting for this whole bluish look. So like I said, just barely. Then I'm gonna go in with the shade Twerk, which is the blue in the palette, with the same brush. And I am really gonna buff that all over my lower lash line from outer to inner. I'm gonna grab my mirror so you guys can see. Okay, then I'm gonna go in with this flat liner brush. It's from Morphe, but any flat brush like this will work. And I'm gonna dip into the blue again. And now I'm really gonna tight line it. So I really wanna push it into that lash line. And I'm gonna go in with this blue eyeliner pencil I have. Sephora brand iKohl, and it is waterproof. And it's in the shade My Boyfriend's Jeans. And then I'm going to take my beauty blender and pull my lid down, and I'm just gonna put this right in my waterline. Okay. Then I'm gonna go in with a white pencil that I have. Just to make it pop a little, I'm gonna put this a little bit on the inner corner over that blue. And it's just gonna brighten up that blue a little bit. Okay, then I'm going to take this brush that I used earlier, thin brush, and I am going to dip in a little bit to the shade, let's see what it's called, Roxanne, and Hunts, back and forth again, and I'm going to buff out this blue. And I'm gonna buff it, mix into a little bit of the shade Creamsicle. So these two shades right here. Mix them a little bit together, tap it off, and then I'm just going to put this on the outer top portion of the lid and kind of pull it in. And it's just gonna really blend out all the rest of those shades. So tap it off. And it's gonna create like this halo effect that's gonna really just widen up the eyes. Hi guys, so I went ahead and applied my eyeliner, which I used the Sephora Noir Black, just the plain one. I love it. I've been through lots of eyeliners, and to be honest, I always use drugstore. The NYC is wonderful, and it's like $3. And then someone introduced me to this one. It is super black, and I love it. Sometimes I do set the inner corner right here with like a black eyeshadow over it, because sometimes that will bleed just a little bit, like not enough to make much of a difference, but sometimes just to be better safe than sorry, I do set it with a black eyeshadow. And then I went in with this Chanel mascara. I don't really know what the name of it is, but it looks like this. So I just applied the mascara to my top lashes. I know that I'm gonna go ahead and apply them to my bottom lashes while I tell you this, but I know that most YouTubers, when they do makeup looks, they do like to use fake lashes. And as much as I love fake lashes, and I love them as much as the next girl, I don't think that it is really necessary to wear them every single day. Because if you wear fake lashes every single day, if you do a full makeup look, or even every single time you do eyeshadow, if you put fake lashes on, yes, it's gonna make your eyeshadow look so much better than it probably would without them. But if you do it every time, then what are you gonna do for a special occasion? And so, to me, I only like to use fake lashes when I am going to some huge event, so that I know that I still have something to look forward to. That when I go to a special event, I can be a little bit more. I can do a little bit more by just adding those fake lashes. Otherwise, it's gonna feel like just everyday makeup to me, and I never want it to feel like that. Every girl wants to have those moments when they feel like they're a little bit more dolled up than they normally are. So I just use mascara. And you can be just as beautiful with just mascara. You don't need fake lashes to make a look pop. Okay, so as I said before, I already had my foundation done and my highlighter done, but I wanted to wait until I had until I was on camera to go ahead and finish my face. Okay guys, so I figured out this video is gonna be super long, so I'm just gonna voice over the rest of this and speed through it. So I'm using the bronzer from the Alexis Rin ColourPop collection in the palette that is called Topaz, and I am applying it with a Morphe R2 brush, just bronzing my cheeks and around my forehead and a little bit underneath my jawbone. And I'm just really buffing it out. I love this brush, I just got it. I also am gonna go and reapply a little bit of translucent setting powder from Laura Mercier underneath my eyes, and I am applying it with a Morphe M438 brush, and also around my nose in spots where women tend to patch due to hormones. Unfortunately, ladies, there's nothing we can do about that. Next, I'm gonna go in with the MAC blush in Peaches. It is a wonderful peachy nude color, and I'm applying it with a Morphe blush brush from that collection that I was using earlier. Next, I'm gonna go in and highlight with the shade in the Jaclyn palette called Beam. I forgot to highlight my brow bone, so I'm just going in with another Morphe brush, a smaller brush, just to pack in that shimmer shade Beam underneath my brow bone. Then I'm going in and brushing my brows with a spoolie and applying the e.l.f. Clear Brow Gel. I know a lot of people like the Anastasia or Anastasia clear brow gel, but I think that the e.l.f. one works great. Next, I'm going to highlight my inner corner, and I am using a Morphe 321 brush, and I decided to apply the shade Beam and In Light from the Jaclyn Hill palette. Now I'm going to highlight my cheekbones, and I'm using MAC Soft and Gentle, and I'm highlighting my cheekbones, a little bit above my brow, my nose, my Cupid's bow. And I'm using a Morphe M510 brush for that. Then I decided that after using that, I wanted to go in with a little bit of Champagne Pop, just because the color of Champagne Pop would really complement this eye look, as well as the blush that I had on. So now I'm prepping my lips with the MAC Prep and Prime. Totally not necessary, but it kind of smoothens your lips. And I waited till it got a little sticky. Then I applied ColourPop lipstick, Ultra Matte Lip in the shade Times Square. And then I set it with Urban Decay Chill Makeup Setting Spray. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope I can get this uploaded before the 4th of July. If not, this is always a great makeup look that you can do anytime. You can take the blue out. You can do it a little less bold. You can add lashes if you want it to be more bold. You can do, a little bit darker of a lip. I wanted to go with a neutral tone. But there are a lot of things that you can do with this look, and a lot of places you can go. It's a great daytime or a nighttime look. I am probably going to the pool tomorrow, so I probably won't do this. However, it's great. I think that Jaclyn Hill's palette is smooth. I think the colors are pigmented. I think they blend seamlessly. I mean, I love the way that this look turned out. So I'm very happy. I'm very pleased with my purchase. And I will definitely continue to use it. If you'd like to see any other looks with it, please let me know. I would really like to start making more videos, and Alex is always trying to convince me to. With that being said, I hope that you enjoyed this look, and I hope that you come back to see more videos. Please leave any comments in the comment section below. I will link every color that I used in this video down below, as well as any other products that I used, including my foundation and my concealer that I used off camera beforehand. I will link that down below. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask, and I will get back to as many of you as I can. Again, thank you for watching, and please subscribe. Bye, guys.